Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Friday. It's a kickback Friday. As you can tell, we're sitting here on the couch. Kind of imagine this if this was just kind of you and me just sitting on the couch. You had some questions for me, and I was going to answer them. So that's what this is all about, kickback Friday. I mean, it used to be Fitness Friday. Now it's kickback Friday. Next week, it won't be kickback Friday. I do want to tell you, before we get into anything else, on this side of the website, so probably about right there, straight up, I think, you'll see a new tab and it says Community. What I want you to do is I want you to go to that when you have an opportunity and check out what we have over there. We are starting a Renegade Health Forum. So there are going to be message boards, you can create a profile, you can create blogs, you can create friends, you can upload pictures, you can upload videos, all this sorts of cool stuff. So up over here is where you can go and you can create your own profile and then start communicating. And, you know, as we develop this will get bigger and bigger and bigger. But right now, just wanted to introduce it to you guys. I haven't sent out an email about it. I won't for a while. But for you guys who are watching the Renegade Health Show regularly, up over here, come and join us and start your discussion. Ask questions. There's going to be a community there of people eventually who can help you, answer. And what I want you to do is please make sure that you introduce yourself and you write a post so people can comment. We have to get it going. That's kind of how this thing starts. It just doesn't, you know, you can't just make it. You have to have people come like you guys and ourselves and just kind of be there and answer questions and talk and create a full community that eventually will, you know, grow its own wings and just become what it's going to become. So I hope you guys enjoy that. That's a completely free service for you guys here at Renegade Health. So enjoy it. So let's get into some questions. Nicole asks, what's the best way to test body fat? Well, the best way to test body fat is actually through displacement, and this water displacement. You do it in a lab and you actually, soak someone in water and, you know, in a big tub of water, and then you can tell what their body fat is. But, you know, that's really not, what we can do. You can use a scale, which we used to have when we were personal trainers. I don't even know if we have this anymore. Or you can use calipers. The calipers or the scale actually aren't as accurate as we'd like them to be, but they give you a good idea, and they give you a good idea as a reference point over time to see if you're losing or if you're gaining body fat. So, you know, do you really need to measure your body fat is really the bigger question, and the answer, I think, is probably not. Unless you want to use that as a marker for your progress, then sure, you can measure body fat, but you don't really need to measure body fat. We don't really need to know. I mean, we can pretty much clearly tell, if someone's going to be unhealthy, or if someone's going to be healthy, just by saying, well, you know, they probably have a lot of body fat over here. They probably don't over here. They're probably healthier on this side. But that's not always true. But you can always usually use that as a pretty good guideline. See, Jasmine says, what are some foods, herbs, exercises that will help nourish my adrenals and kidneys and stress levels? Also, what foods, herbs, and exercises should I avoid? So exercises to avoid are high-intensity exercises. So really, really fast interval training, things like that, that'll burn the adrenals a little bit too high. Herbs that you want to avoid, any sort of food and herb that are stimulants. So any sort of processed sugars you want to avoid. Even some of the non-processed sugars, maybe even too much honey will burn you a little too thin. Obviously agave. Herbs you want to, and chocolate. Herbs that you want to avoid, you want to avoid stimulating herbs, things that raise your heart rate, you know, kind of get you going, make you a little speedy. So those are the things to avoid. What do you need to support them? You need B vitamins, you need minerals, you need adaptogens work, holy basil, which is Tulsi as well, rhodiola, ginseng, things like that, adaptogens. And exercises are more aerobic, so long, steady, the LSD, long, slow distance kind of running, or walking or hiking or things like that. That's what's going to help you out best. And for stress, you can use EFT, you can use, any sort of meditation. I use walking or running as a meditation, but just anything to cool you down. And remember that stress is your reaction to the situation. It's not everyone else's, so you can change that, because some people can be stressed about something that someone may not. So why? It's because of you. Let's see here. Nick talks about coca leaves. I wonder if there's been any research in regards to side effects or withdrawal after consuming the leaves over a period of time. So I'm reading a book now. It's called Cocaine, the Unauthorized Biography. And the reason why I'm reading this is because I wanted to see the difference between coca and cocaine. And there's a lot of history that transpired over, maybe 100 years about, how coca leaves became demonized because of the effects that cocaine has on people, and transferring that back into the actual leaf, you know, the properties of cocaine back into the leaf, you know, was what they wanted to do, the scientists and some of the political figures wanted to, but it just doesn't work because the alkaloid is so diluted in the actual leaf that you don't get the same effects. It doesn't have addictive effects. It actually has beneficial effects. So there's no addictive properties of the coca leaf. There's obviously addictive properties of cocaine. Did you guys know that they used to prescribe cocaine as a way to break your addiction to heroin? I mean, this is the same, you know, medical societies that are, you know, giving us our that are giving us our pharmaceutical drugs right now. So just be aware of that. I want you to be very clear that, you know, they've messed up before. But anyway, so these are some of the things that have happened with the coca leaf over time. 4,000 or 5,000, 6,000 years of no issues with the coca leaf until we came along. And I mean, we, by kind of Western society, even European society, came along and then decided that it was bad. And then, you know, started to demonize it. So who knows? You know, just leave it alone, guys. Leave it alone. All right, let's see here. Cacao. There's a question on cacao that I want to get to before we end today's show. Cheryl asks, why do raw foodists who know that cacao is harmful to the mind and body keep supporting it? I believe this was in reference to the little peanut butter cups that we put up, the recipe. So Cheryl, here's my comment here is these little peanut butter cups, you know, I might have cacao every, and not even cacao, just chocolate. You know, I actually kind of don't eat the raw stuff anymore. Might have, you know, a little bit of, you know, like a chocolate thing, a little dessert with like a honey or something like that. Once every 2-3 months, I mean, just a little bit, that's it. I mean, you know, you can't tell me that, you know, everyone out there is completely perfect, that, you know, they don't have anything. Like, you know, you don't have a glass of wine ever. You don't have, you know, a little bit of sugar ever. You don't ever get angry. You don't ever do this. And all these things, you know, can cause a little bit of stress in the body and cause a little harm. It's when you use cacao as an everyday thing, as something that you believe to be a health food when it's actually a treat, or as Jameis says, a legal recreational drug, you know, that's when it becomes an issue. And so, you know, there's these varying, you know, there's this black and white thing that's just proliferated through the health world that, you know, we just have to shut it down. We have to shut down the black and white. We have to be as clean as possible, and we have to really work with ourselves and inside of our mind structures, you know, the structures that create like bad and good, and be gentle with them, you know, be very gentle with them. So yes, I mean, you, if you want a piece of chocolate every 2 or 3 months, cool. But, you know, that's really where it should be. And so if you're eating it every week, or if you're eating it, you know, every day, then stop. You know, I'm just from my own personal experience to you, stop, please. You know, just relax on it. You're going to harm yourself. I can't promise you it, but, you know, just watch out. Watch out for the signs. They'll come. All right, let's see here. Last question here is, what are some reliable you guys are going to think I staged this, but this is the last. What are some reliable places to purchase some raw foods online? Hemp seed, things like that. You can purchase them at the Renegade Health Store. So let me, and you can find that up over here. But let me answer another question just to end it out, so you guys don't think I staged that. Last question here from Stephanie is: did you and Emery take vaccination shots before going to Peru? No, we did not. It's not required in Peru, by the way. If you were going to Africa, Congo, would you? This would be a question I would ask Dr. Williams. I do not know the answer to this, and if I would go to Africa, I would say, hey, Dr. Williams, since he's been studying viral immunity and he's been studying tribal people for a long time, and he's been in the jungles and all sort of stuff, I would ask him and say, what should I do? And I would respect his opinion, and I would do whatever he says. So, you know, that's where I would go with that. So, your question of the day is, let's talk about it again. Let's talk about cacao. Let's talk about, you know, what do you do? You know, do you have cacao on a regular basis? Why? Is there something that you do too much? Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Be sure to get up over here and go to the community. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.